Do you love the Earth? If you do, it's probably because you see the Earth as a living being instead of just some big round rock floating in space that just so happens to have some living organisms growing on the surface. After all, you can't love something that is dead or that you consider to be dead. Now, this picture shows a being I call MetaGaia. Now, you're probably already familiar with the concept of Gaia, that Earth is a living organism. But I believe that planet Earth and its biosphere is not an organism, but an organ system in the body of the solar system. Planet Earth and its biosphere is the heart chakra, or heart planet, of the solar system, functioning as the heart, lungs, and digestive system of this cosmic scale, photosynthetic organism. So, you see, the heart of this being is taking the form of a monad calendar clock, which you may not be familiar with, so I'm going to show you what that looks like. Here it is right here. This is the monad calendar clock app, and here you see planet Earth at the center of a time and date-telling celestial ring. Here's the south side, and this is the north side, featuring the entire north hemisphere of Earth. That little white thing at the center is the north polar spinning axis. So you set this in motion, and you can see that it's spinning around the north pole. And the thing that's spinning here, this white object right there, is the hour hand, which marks the location on the globe. I'm located here in Northern California, so that's where my hour hand is located. But you can move that hour hand anywhere around the globe and tell the time and date from any location on the globe. Hit the here button, it brings you back to the current time and date. So this is the heart chakra of the solar system. Once again, let's go back to this picture here, and you can see at the center of this being, at the level of the heart, is the calendar clock mechanism, Earth at the center of the celestial ring. So back to this, all living organisms, both plants and animals, have biorhythms. And Earth is a photosynthetic organism. This is the important part to understand here. Let's go back once again to this page here. And this is a page on my website, which I hope you will check out. Let's go all the way to the top up here. This is my website, earthatthecenter.com. And this page is Heart of the Solar System, which is located here under Chronobiology, one of the main links at the top. Hit Heart of the Solar System. And there it is. This is a video that I think you should check out. It explains everything about that picture and how Earth is the heart planet of the solar system, functioning as a heart, lungs, and digestive system of this photosynthetic organism. Here's where I talk about the biomass distribution, which planet Earth has a predominantly plant-based biosphere. 83% of the biomass of the biosphere organisms is made up of plants. So it's a photosynthetic organism, basically. And the biorhythms of the solar system are photosynthetic biorhythms involving the distribution of light from the sun and moon to plants growing on the surface of the Earth. So it's easy to demonstrate these three planetary biorhythms. The solar day is the time it takes for the Earth to make a complete rotation relative to the sun, night and day, separated by the Earth's circle of illumination. This line separating the light half from the dark half of Earth. And night and day, that's equivalent to a photosynthetic heartbeat. Systole, diastole, night and day. Then here you can see this is the moon orbiting the Earth, going through its phases, and this is the equivalent of a breath of the solar system, but instead of for animal cells, which perform cellular respiration, plants do a photosynthesis, and they're extremely sensitive to light. Even the light of the moon has an impact on plants. It's equivalent to the breathing cycle. Then the last photosynthetic biorhythm of this cosmic being is the seasonal year, which is the time it takes for the sun to apparently circle the ecliptic. This tilted red circle here is the ecliptic. And I'm going to hit the now button. You can see that we just passed up the winter solstice position, where the sun is at its deepest position in the southern hemisphere. This is the southern hemisphere, and here this is the northern hemisphere, separated by the Earth's equatorial plane. And where the ecliptic crosses the celestial equator right here, this is the descending equinoctial node. That's the fall equinox. And over here is the spring equinox, where the sun ascends from the southern to the northern hemisphere. So let's watch what happens here as the sun advances. I'm going to speed this up, and you can see how the sun is now ascending. There's the ascending spring equinoctial node. And now this would be the summer solstice position right there. So these are all photosynthetic biorhythms of this photosynthetic being, MetaGaia. Just imagine this in action, all of these biorhythms taking place in this cosmic photosynthetic organism, which is complementary to our animal body. As it shows here, the solar system is a great man, and man is a small solar system. So once again, all of this is explained in a great deal of detail on this webpage and on this video here. And I hope you'll check it out. And thank you very much. All right.